traveling faster than ever.
Seems like no one's on the scene.
People start gathering rations, stop laughing.
This isn't a place to be.
Switch up your style, take action to show up.
That's a disease.
People be ready, they all have a time.
Sunday, you're repeating the same thing. Don't focus over here at the door. Since we're laughing, we adjust your last game. Stop acting me right like you are doing now. Stop playing, stop faking, stop taking the spicy for granted. Tomorrow's not promised to you.
Nobody's saying how dirty you want it. Do your first works over, yeah. Pseudo salvation, where is the foundation? Now praise and worship's a trend. Gospel's the power of God unto someone's salvation.
Sunday after Sunday, repeating the same thing.
What's going on, y'all? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Hope that you all are having a wonderful Tuesday evening. I hope that your holidays are going well, that Christmas went well for you, also with New Year's on the way, quickly approaching. I hope that you have an amazing New Year as well. And baby, the universe is doing a hell of a goddamn last call before the end of the year in reference to just the age that we are slowly but surely ushering ourselves into. Okay? As wise mystics have said, girl, these next 2,000 plus years about to be lit and off the goddamn chain, because now truth that you cannot control, truth that is all the way objective, it has no sort of subjective, we're talking about the overall general truth. The truth where every knee shall bow and tongue shall confess, for the religious people out there. And I've said it before and I will say it again. Nobody is exempt from this mass awakening of truth, okay? Every single one of us is going to have to learn how to accept objective truths within our own lives, whether it be behind closed doors, in front of thousands and millions of people, or a combination of both of those things. And the lie that I originally was going to do was just me up here and kind of just speaking from what I'm seeing in the world today, as far as this common theme of fear and ignorance. They say the ultimate sin, or the only sin that there is the sin of ignorance. And because of ignorance, I mean, we can't be confused at all of what's happening now in the world, because there's a lack of love there. There's a lack of redemption there. Okay? But again, we are also objective as well. We try our best to be as objective. Now, I was sent information about this individual a few days ago, and I went through the messages again, because I'm getting messages daily that keeps me up to date with a lot of stuff that's going on in reference to queerness and the narratives around it. And I said, you know what? Let me go ahead and use this as an opportunity to show people what accountability looks like. But again, accountability across the board. This is not the moving of the goalpost, girl. This, if anything, this is just the awareness of how big and wide the goalpost is. Just because you kick it in this one area does not mean we got a whole bunch of this area over here too. Now, before we get into tonight's live, and I finally have to pull it up for the first time. Amen. Boom. Copyright disclaimer under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976. Allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, education, and research. Fair use is a use permitted by copyright statute that might otherwise be infringing. Nonprofit, educational, or personal use tips the balance in favor of fair use. Okay, because we're going to be listening to two clips. One from, I think it's called, girl, what the name of that shit called? Yeah. The first live or video we're going to use is from the One America News Network. And the other is from our favorite Grifton brothers in light skin Christ, girl, the Hodge twins. Shout out to the Hodge twins, girl. And what we're going to do is we're going to hold Miss Kendall accountable, because she's been charged. We'll get into it. What we're going to do first, actually, is we're going to read the news article first, and then we're going to get into the videos, okay? So again, if you want to read along with me, the link for this news article is in the description box below, and it reads, Trans activist Kendall Stephens arrested sparks MAGA uproar. The arrest of 37-year-old LGBTQ plus activist Kendall Stephens sparked social media discourse on Tuesday. Stephens was arrested Monday on charges including rape, indecent assault, endangering the welfare of a child, corruption of a minor, and related charges on Monday following a comprehensive investigation, a Philadelphia Police Department spokesman told Newsweek. Stephens, who is transgender, is known as a prominent LGBTQ plus rights activist in Philadelphia. Her arrest comes amid a cultural clash between conservatives and the LGBTQ plus community. Conservatives have long opposed the expansion of queer rights, but many in the community have warned of an uptick of homophobia and transphobia, as well as an increased anti-LGBTQ plus legislation. They have also warned of the spread of grooming accusations against the community. Critics say grooming allegations baselessly associate the community with pedo behavior, pointing to a lack of evidence showing LGBTQ plus people are no more likely to commit those acts than the general population. The investigation into Stephens began after Philadelphia's Police Special Victims Unit received reports of previous sexual assaults on two minor children in September, the department says. A spokesperson for the Pennsylvania Attorney General's office confirmed to Newsweek that charges were referred after being filed by the Philadelphia Police Department. Philadelphia news stations WCAU reported that the victims were two boys, age 9 and 14. The grandmother of one of the victims reported to police on September 25th that Stephens allegedly assaulted her grandson. Stephens is accused of abusing one boy at least three separate times since 2022, the news station reported. The second boy told police he was also assaulted by Stephens and that she provided him gifts out of nowhere, WCAU reported. She allegedly told one of the victims he would be locked up if he told anyone about the abuse, the station reported. Newsweek reached out to Stephens via Instagram for comment. It is unclear if she has an attorney. News of her arrest was shared on social media by several high-profile conservative influencers. And this is from Colin Rugg. 37-year-old transgender Kendall Stephens has been arrested for allegedly raping two minors under the age of 13. This is why the death penalty exists. Stephens is a vocal LGBTQ plus activist and even worked with lawmakers to protect the LGBTQ plus community. Okay. Conservative commentator Ole London wrote on X, Stephens has been considered a prominent activist for the LGBTQ plus community and previously urged lawmakers to change Pennsylvania's hate crime statute to include protections for LGBTQ plus people. Others, however, raised concerns about the response to her arrest. The Kendall Stephens discourse is so rough because it also just invites unnecessary transphobia. She should be made accountable for her actions for sure, but all the false equivalency of pedo behavior to LGBT plus people is 100% invalid, wrote X user Rashid. And I think that is the end of the article. So I'm glad they ended the article in that way, because that's exactly what my commentary is going to be about on tonight. Okay? Now, again, Kendall has been charged, okay, with sexual abuse against a 9-year-old and a 14-year-old. If through the investigation and going through courts we see evidence of that, that she has done that, then yes, by all means, homegirl ass need to be in prison. If she is convicted of doing that and they have objective proof that that is the case, because again, all this is still allegedly. She's been charged with this, but she is innocent until proven guilty. That's in the eyes of the law. But we're talking about the court of public opinion here, and this is where the shit gets dangerous. Because just like it was stated at the end of that article, that there's going to be this false equivalency placed on the queer community at large. And with me being an individual who, for the past year and a half, went to other platforms to listen to how they speak about queerness, especially in the Black community, they're all saying the same thing about queerness. They don't want it around. They don't even want to tolerate it, because if you tolerate it, this is what happens. This is what the prominent leaders in that community are doing. They're making these laws and creating these laws and enacting these laws so they can go ahead and do their shit in your face, and you can't do nothing about it because the law protects them. And when we do our research, that same verbiage, literally the same script played over in Uganda, to where all it took was one incident that was alleged. For them to get the Kill the Gays bill enacted over in Uganda. And we're heading into the political year with the political season. Listen, queerness is going to be on the ballot. And for the queer people that are listening to this, I keep telling y'all, I don't be saying this to y'all to terrify y'all or, you know, to fearmonger, but I need y'all to really be aware of what's going on and how people are going to treat you. Because this is what they think about the community at large. Again, I'm not saying that Ms. Kendall is exempt. Again, if she is charged and there is evidence on that, she needs to be held accountable. But the dangerous thing overall, not just for queer people, because baby, when you make it dangerous for queer people, you make it dangerous for your damn self. What this is doing is opening up the can of worms on everybody. We're seeing from the highest of heights to the lowest of lows, girl, and everything in between is being checked and being exposed by the universe. Because all this situation is going to do at large is really just expose people's queerphobia, because now they found something. Not no overwhelming objective evidence that even Bubzdagawd is a part of, all the queer people are connected, we can criminalize all of them objectively because we see them do it, we have proof, not because of that. But the fact that this one situation is basically the clarion call that is needed. We just read the tweet about someone saying that this is why the death penalty exists. But anyway, let's get into the first video we're going to listen to from, again, One America News Network. Okay? And they want to give their opinion and their perspective and their perception, okay, on the whole situation with Ms. Kendall Stephens being arrested for alleged sexual abuse. Okay, let's get into that now.
Tipping Point, I'm your host, Kara McKinney. Who would have guessed that a radical left-wing trans activist would also be a credibly accused pedo? Isn't that just right-wing fear-mongering and bigotry? No, it turns out our fears are justified once again, because Kendall Stephens of Philadelphia was arrested this week on charges that he, because yes, this is a man pretending to be a woman, raped two young boys under the age of 13. His bail has been set at $250,000, and his first court appearance is scheduled for December 29th. Interesting how just a month or two ago, he was on local news being interviewed about the tragic death, he says, of his close friend and fellow left-wing LGBTQ activist, Josh Krueger. The 39-year-old was shot dead inside his Philadelphia home back in October. But the suspect in this case is 19-year-old Robert Davis, who gave authorities text messages and other evidence which he claims shows that Krueger had been supplying him with drugs and sexually abusing him since he was a 15-year-old minor in need of help from social workers. Birds of a feather flock together. Here's Stephen singing Krueger's praises.
He was able to use his platform as a journalist to advocate on the behalf of those who are often rendered voiceless and invisible. And not many of us are able to exercise platforms where we're able to speak truth to power. And he was able to speak for those of us that just could not do so. So to lose that connection to the public, to lose that connection to politicians, that is a devastating blow to our community. And he cannot be replaced.
Well, thanks for everything you do, too.
Thank you. You know.
So this Kendall Stephens guy is highly placed in local political circles. He stood behind Soros-backed District Attorney Larry Krasner in his 2021 presser, announcing the launch of the LGBTQ plus advisory board after claiming to be the victim of a violent transphobic attack himself. He also joined Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro on the campaign trail. Stephens also appears to have attended a gala for the gay activist organization, the Human Rights Campaign, and did this bizarre voguing dance popular in gay, trans, and drag queen circles.
He's showing her dancing. And she over doing a crybaby on the floor. It's Kendall.
And yes, there was no other reason for me to show you that video except for the fact that since I had to see it, you have to see it too. Misery loves company and all that. And speaking of seeing things that you don't want to see that will burn out your retinas, remember that Democrat staffer fired a few days ago from Maryland Senator Ben Cardin's office for allegedly filming and then uploading a gay porno he filmed with another man naked with only some leather straps on inside of a Senate hearing room?
Wow.
Well, there were a lot of bad takes from the left on this, but this headline from Afru takes the cake. It says, fired for his act of love in the Senate, Aiden Mays-Sharofsky's act was symbolic and brave because in a world full of hate, displays of love are rebellious. We shouldn't bend over to a party that hates. We must do the opposite. Now, I know what you might be thinking, because I was thinking the same thing when I first saw this headline, that yes, it's shocking, but it's from some fringe, obscure left-wing publication that no one's ever heard of, so who cares what crazy things they say? But guess what? I did a little bit of digging, and on their own website, they disclosed that they received funding from Google, the Ford Foundation, and from the Kingdom of Norway. The Kingdom of Norway part is a little random, but wow, those are some major donors. So obviously there's something valuable, I guess, about this group that wants us to think that filming gay porn inside the Senate is just an act of love that only hateful people want to destroy. Joining me now to discuss all this and more is Terry Schilling, the president of the American Principles Project. Terry, thanks for being here tonight.
Thanks for having me, Kara.
So kind of amazing, right, that this left-wing group, Afru or whatever, that gets money from Google and the Ford Foundation, I guess Norway's kingdom, wants us to think that poor little Aiden, the Democrat staffer, he's the real victim here, and he's being persecuted for daring to love. Why do you hate love so much, Terry? These people are incorrigible. I don't have words for this, but how about you?
Well, look, this has happened in many other countries. What it really is, Kara, is it is the full corruption of our national media system, right? This is worse than Prada, which was the propaganda outlet that the Soviets had. This is worse than anything they have in China. What we're seeing is a free market totally corrupt and be totally turned inside out, and they're trying to gaslight all of us. This staffer was obviously fired for having sexual relations in a Senate room, but not just that, for filming it and then sharing it.
And again, that the link for that video is in the description box below. Again, I'm going to state, if Ms. Kendall is found guilty on all of these charges against her, yes, Miss Homegirl is going to have to do the motherfucking time for doing the motherfucking crime. And again, I don't mind having the conversation about children unfortunately being abused sexually by adults, but the issue here is that there is this broad generalization to say that queer people are the ones who do it exclusively. Because this whole narrative of protect the children, the queer people are after your children, the queer people are after your children, when in reality, there are deviant sexual human beings that are trying to put some form of power and control over children, and they're using the medium of sex to do it. And again, this is all alleged. There is still information and context and nuance that we need. But I want to go ahead and read the comments. And for the dude that was fucking in the building, bro, again, I agree with old dude, bro. You shouldn't be doing that. This is a place of employment. This is a sacred place, I guess, in reference to the eyes of the law. But at the same time, let's not act like there ain't motherfuckers that be fucking and having sex all up and through their damn jobs everywhere. It's just that this individual went so far to just record himself doing it, and he's a high public official. That's where he got fucked up at. Let's read some of the comments underneath that video, because my purpose for this live is to, yes, hold Miss Kendall accountable, because again, just because you trans don't mean that, oh girl, we gonna look the other way. Hell no, girl, this is the age of accountability. It's gonna whoop everybody ass, me, yours, and everybody in between. Okay, I'm here to help also expose the queerphobia and the fear-based ideology that they have against the queer community as a whole. So let's look at some of the comments. And there's 161 of them. Someone says, thank you, Owen, for saying he. Someone else says, corn isn't love. Exposing your sexual partner on film to others isn't love. And in fact, sex and love are not the same thing. It's not appropriate to have sex with all the things, living or not, that you love. Certainly not all the people or animals you love. Even loving a person romantically doesn't mean you must have sex. Being respectful and responsible has to be a large part of love. Someone else says that this is the Democrat idea of human rights. Remember, they have their own definitions for everything. Someone else says, what a bunch of creepy creatures. Someone else says, an act of love. Clearly, that certain group of people have love and lust confused, and they think those words mean the same thing. Someone else says, I'm pretty sure that this makes Kendall Stephens officially the newest Disney princess. Someone else says, nobody should ever trust these people. Someone said, Joe Biden is proud of this man. Someone else says, so now people are calling casual sex love? So if I go out, drink a lot of alcohol, and have sex with a complete stranger, that's now called love is love? Someone else says, we've been humoring this madness for far too long. This is shocking to absolutely nobody, okay? Why does truth to power even mean? Shouldn't it be power in the truth? Someone else says, told you, we're not conspiracy theorists. We're pattern recognition specialists. It's a lot of stuff. The definition of freak hasn't changed, just new names to cover it up. There's a lot of comments. What a shocker, if the shoe fits. Again, what in the LGBTQP? Didn't they write a song about coming for your children? Wolves in women's clothing. Sick. He will walk, protected class. Wow. And these are just some of the comments about the queer community, girl, off of this one situation that again is alleged, and we have to go through court and all that stuff and see all the evidence, because again, this is alleged. Okay, alleged here. Now the second video that we're going to listen to is from the Hodge twins. Okay, so they're going to share their perception and perspective, okay, about the whole Kendall Stephens situation and just the queer community overall. Okay, because I want you to listen to the verbiage that is being used. And not saying some queer people or a few queer people. It's just those people, those people, those people. Let's listen.
Yeah, I got a new show for y'all. Got a damn good show.
Well, we got this trans activist doing, she's fighting for her rights. Well, he's fighting for whatever it is.
No, she...
There's trans rights is human rights. That's what them fools say.
Well, this
trans rights is human rights. I don't even know what that means. Trans rights is human rights. Is black rights human rights too? It's stupid, right? It's a twist. It's a wordplay. They're gaslighting everybody.
What's right? Up, extra smoke?
They're twisting everybody's perceptions so they can take advantage of you. These gay people are methodical.
Let me say something. Well, this trans activist got arrested for doing
what?
I would say it's probably typical trans behavior.
Typical trans behavior.
What, glory
holes? I think a bunch of them are sexual deviants.
What, glory holes?
No, we'll see. Watch.
Circle jerks?
Even worse. Ten times worse than
a circle jerk?
It could go to video.
So we're the sexual deviants. Meanwhile, these are the two men who I grew up watching their videos before they became grifters, where they were talking about cream pieing and balls deep and, you know, sugar walls. All that type of stuff. And they just sat there talking about blowjobs, circle jerks, all this type of shit. I mean, we can really have the conversation because, let's be honest, if we're going to talk about sexual deviance, men overall are sexual deviants. Let's play that game. Whether your ass a straight man or a gay man, you like busting nuts. What did Bernie Mac say to you motherfuckers, bro?
We serving one purpose. That's a nut. That bastard ain't number 3.5-4 motherfucking seconds. A nut ain't shit. Think about it. You bust your ass off for a 4.5-second nut. You gotta be a sick motherfucker. Motherfucker bust your heart wide open. It couldn't be no 15-second nut. It'd be some drop dead motherfuckers around here, man. Can you imagine a 20-second nut? You'd be a falling out motherfucker.
Okay, you'd be a falling out motherfucker. And I don't know, maybe in the age of Aquarius, God gonna bless me and girl with a gift and a curse of a 20-second nut, girl. And some people say that's a beautiful way to die, and I agree. But do you even see how I talk about it? Like, men are just sexual in general. And this society has taught us to be over-sexual. Here it is, they're about to talk about, oh, these people are sexual deviants. These people, is typical trans behavior. But yet, y'all talking about the sexual shit, and you probably do the sexual shit too because y'all have more freedom to do it than we do. Y'all have more freedom to speak about it without much objection to it. So let's continue further.
Jeez.
Now the details here. Philadelphia transgender
activist. Woo, pause that video. That woman. That's what I'm talking about. Look at them cowburn hips. That's what I call a woman right there.
Yeah, dude, you can't handle all that woman. You can't handle that.
Look, that's a woman. Right? Look at them hips.
Yeah, that's a woman right there.
You talking about the news back, anchor?
She's
a biological.
That's a trans woman.
I thought that was somebody's old black grandma.
They talking about Kendall
look
now.
Crazy hair.
We got a blonde wig on or something. All right, let's go.
That ain't highlights.
Kendall Stephens is now charged with sexually assaulting two children under the age of 13.
Action News reporter Annie McCormick, she's live for us outside police headquarters with the new details we're learning about this, Annie.
Yeah, Gray and Shari, disturbing details. Kendall Stephens was arrested today for the rape of a minor. Sources confirmed that she is the same Stephens who is a prominent LGBTQ activist in the city. The state attorney general's office filed charges tonight against 37-year-old Kendall Stephens. The charges include the indecent assault against a person less than 13 years old, rape, unlawful contact with minor, sexual offenses, and endangering the welfare of children, parent, or guardian. Stephens came to Action News in August of 2020 after she was attacked in her Point Breeze neighborhood. She says she was targeted by a violent group for being a trans woman. Stephens.
And you can see the video they show, and I want to pause that. Trans women are being attacked. They are being ostracized because, again, there is this narrative that is being spun. You've read it. We've heard the comments, not just on this particular live and the further comments we're going to read, but just in past situations and lives and experiences and panels. There is this fear-based ideology that's placed on all queer people. To even when I share my own experience about never being sexually abused growing up, that people did not want to believe that. It was like, no, that's the only way. That's how you became queer. It's just like, so trans women are getting attacked. And the fact that Miss Kendall, again, is alleged to have done this and is being charged with this, all that's going to do is just add more gasoline on the fire, the weak ass fire of queerphobia that is waiting to spring out of its covert state into its overt state. And if y'all want to play the game about protecting the children, I already told y'all, I'm cool with that. But let's do it across the board. Let's have the same level of smoke across the board. Nobody in the chat was saying, oh, well, we got to wait until we see what the court of law is and the court appearance and all this stuff. We got to see what's going on. There has to be evidence. Is this going to go to trial? If this goes to trial, then we'll be able to look at it and see what's going on. But right now, this is alleged. But look at how the court of public opinion is responding. And the court of public opinion is the place where we got to live at and live with, because the people that are part of the court of public opinion also live in real life with all of us. And as much as people want to sit up here and say, oh, queer people are a protected group of people, no, we're not. Especially now that this story has come out. The fact that people are going to run with the narrative and automatically go to conclusion shopping as opposed to being objective and looking at everything and the facts and the context and nuance of everything. Let's continue further.
Then became a prominent activist for the LGBTQ community. She urged lawmakers to change Pennsylvania's hate crime statute to include protections for LGBTQ people. She is seen here in March of 2021 at a press conference launching District Attorney Larry Krasner's LGBTQ Plus Advisory Board. The board was created in part to be a source of information and resources for victims and survivors of crime within the community.
It means to me that the transgender population will finally get the support that we need from city officials that we really haven't gotten historically.
Sources tell Action News the charges are in relation to the rape of two young boys under the age of 13. Stevens remains in custody tonight. A spokesperson for the district attorney's office said in a statement, the investigation of allegations against her is being led by another agency, and as such, we have no comment. Now, Judge did set bail at $250,000. The next court appearance is scheduled for December 29th. The state attorney general's office takes on cases from local district attorney's offices if there's a conflict. Now, reporting live outside of Philadelphia Police headquarters, Annie McCormick for Action News at 10 on PHL 17. Gray and Shari.
Yeah, Annie. There's another one right there. You see that black one?
Yeah.
Got a black one and a white one. Top echelon one.
You know that transgender, you see how she wore glasses? Every person I knew that wore the glasses like that, they always been batshit crazy. And the reason why, I remember I asked my friend, because he wore his glasses like that. He wasn't transgender, he was just an idiot, right? I said, why you wear your glasses like that? He said, I'm trying to make my nose to grow keen, because he had a wide-ass nose. So he would bring his glasses down, try to close that shit up. Wow. And he thought his nose was going to grow closer as he...
Yeah, more keen.
Nah, he's
not all wide and covering up his face.
Yeah, this was, he was like 13 when he's doing it. That's what his mom was saying. And that dude grew up in high school, man, his nose is wide as all outdoors. Ain't nothing, you can't change genetics.
Now let's get back
that's
to the
That's why trends. She was wearing a glass like that, because her nose is wide as hell. She don't like it. So she'll bring her glasses down further, right? Try to close all that wide.
Yeah, she got them, I think those are implants, the cheekbones.
Yeah, them cheekbones. Them cheekbones ain't real.
Cheekbones like...
Like Asians.
Yeah, like Asians have king cheekbones.
Yeah.
I ain't never seen no black woman no cheekbones like that. Them cheekbones like...
Like plates.
Like you've been... Like, you ever seen a squirrel eat? Yeah, them, like a... No, a pack rat. Cheeks all big.
Isla Condola.
You look like with some glasses off the tip of your nose. But this doesn't surprise me, because that whole community.
Yeah, sexual.
It's like
that everything about community. That lifestyle is everything.
Hey, man, can I do some talking?
No, I was just going to say that whole life is sucking around.
Yeah, I'm in the middle of that. Let me say it.
The whole lifestyle is sucking around semen.
That whole life.
Semen and penises.
Hey, Kevin, let me say something.
I bet you. I'll put some money on it. Man. The average homosexual. Transgender? I bet you they bust.
Hey, man, what you get serious, man?
You know they deviants, right?
Especially
not this all transgenders as classy as Caitlyn Jenner. Caitlyn Jenner, she's classy. Blair White, classy transgender, right?
Yeah.
Then you got your whores, right? And majority of these whores, they come from the left. You take a conservative transgender, and you take one of these left-leaning transgenders. Totally.
That's a good point.
Totally two different papers.
That's a good point.
Yeah. Yeah.
I am. Let me say something. I forgot what I was gonna say.
Just like the liberal Negro, and then you take the conservative Negro. Yeah. Totally two different people. Totally two different perspectives in life. Yeah. You know, it's almost like what's keeping them from progressing in life is their mindset, their perspective, how they see things, their stance on things.
Yeah.
Now, if they was more conservative leaning, they wouldn't be out here busting all them nuts.
Hey, let me
say
they
wouldn't be in all these glory holes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They wouldn't be participating in all these circle jerks.
Yeah.
There would be more. There would be. Intense.
You said enough. So I think like this transgender, it highlights like transgenders. Like I used to think all of them like just gay. They're not even gay.
Yeah.
This transgender is raping young boys.
Yeah.
But it's probably didn't hold them down and.
More likely the kids.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm looking at this from the wrong angle. It's 13 years old. She probably had sex with them, penetrating them.
Why you say that? Well, who knows? They're gay. I don't think she took advantage of a straight kid.
So I don't think the kids penetrated it. I think it penetrated the kids.
You think it? You don't think it was the other way around?
Yeah.
Well, hey, Keith, we're talking about gay people.
Wow. Right? You never know what's going down in the gay bedroom.
Yeah. I mean, they're very versatile, you know? Like straight people, you know, it's a couple of positions, but gay? It's endless. You know? I mean,
nah,
who
I
you think invented circle jerks? You think straight people came up with that?
Hey, Keith, what's wrong with
you? Who you think invented the glory hole? Think a straight guy?
No, I think a straight guy came with that, and then
no.
Well,
a straight guy came on glory holes.
Yep,
in bathrooms. And no, I don't think so. That was invented by homosexuals.
No, I'm thinking a straight guy came up with that, and then the gay man exploited it and made it into something deviant and evil. When it was something beautiful between.
Man. I think it originated from gay dudes didn't want nobody to see their face when they getting sucked off.
Closet,
I think
homosexual.
A closet homosexual.
I live in Detroit, so that didn't scare me. Oh girl, they shooting already. That was the Hodge Twins' perspective on it. And again, I mean, I am not surprised. Like, I don't have to lie. I don't have to lie. I don't have to lie. I'm literally responding to what is objectively out there. And speaking of objectivity and how they feel, let's look at some of the comments. Okay. Someone said, it's disturbing that he was able to get children alone anywhere. We are failing at protecting children. Someone else says, we see this kind of behavior occurring once we pretend moral values don't exist. Someone else said, he should be held accountable for his actions. Someone else said, they don't recognize sexes, why would they recognize age? Someone else said, the people in the neighborhood knew what the guy was doing and he used the system to protect himself. The truth will always come out. Evil will reveal itself. Someone else said, the fact that they will record this as a crime by female is irritating. Someone else says, I guess the song We're Coming for Your Children was spot on. Someone else says, there's perverts of all flavors and colors, but what irritates me is when we aren't allowed to call out the behavior because of irrelevant BS like racism, transphobia, etc. I don't care what group you are part of. Predator behavior is predator behavior. Due to the protections for some groups enjoy, people are using them to act out disgusting desires. Wonder if any people noticed or knew but were regarded as transphobic? Nobody wants to be jumped all over and labeled as a bigot for asking questions, challenging things, and everyone wants to celebrate folks regardless of character. I don't hate anyone for their choices, but now I'm starting to hate people for their choices. This is becoming more and more common. When are people going to start noticing patterns? How much you want to bet that he didn't get attacked for being trans, but he got attacked for being a fan of the playground? If only there were some sort of warning signs, this could have been prevented. We're here, we're queer, we're coming for your children, they told us. Someone else says, I'm shocked, completely and totally shocked. Okay, maybe not that shocked. Pretty sure everyone who isn't one of them saw this coming. Someone else says, so during their parades and they chant, we are coming after your children, we should probably take them at their word. Just the comments are endless, endless comments, endless comments, endless comments. Again, I am not sitting here justifying any of Ms. Kendall's actions in regards to what she's charged for. We are going to wait and see what the court of law does with the situation. We're going to wait for the facts to come out. We're going to wait for trial, testimonials, all that type of stuff to come out, so that if this is in fact and indeed the case, that she does end up being held accountable. But now the issue is that there are people out here that are going to take that story and apply it onto all of queerness, including me, to say that if we allow these queer people to have their rights and to have their freedom, this is what their freedom looks like. They're going to do it to the children. They already doing it to the adults in Hollyweird by making them bend over and take shit up, take shit up their ass. All of a sudden now they're doing it to our children. And I'm about protecting the children, because I was a queer child and I was not protected. So I am about protecting the children. But again, if we're going to do protect the children, as the title reads, make sure you have blood on your doorpost, or in the words of Andrew Caldwell, and in my Caldwellian voice or Caldwellian language, blood on your Doekosh. Because accountability is coming for everybody, and it's across the board. So yes, let's continue to hold Ms. Kendall accountable. But let's continue to hold everybody else accountable that is fucking on kids. That Epstein list still has not been investigated yet, huh? Since y'all want to talk about it. And queer people, I'm telling you right now, in 2024, you need to find a way to defend yourself with your hands, with your elbows, knees, and feet, as well as some sort of a tangible weapon. Because there are some people who, when they see you, they're going to see Ms. Kendall. And they're going to attack you, because now it's going to be okay to attack the weird people. Now we have the green light to attack the weird people. And the shit that's happening over in Uganda, I would be a fool to sit up here and believe that it cannot happen here in America. Because the same script is being played right in front of us. So anyway, please leave your thoughts down below, whether you agree, disagree. Let's find the amalgamation of some sort of answer. Again, Ms. Kendall is being held accountable. Her ass is locked up. She's on a $250,000 bail. And it looks as if though this is going to be going to court. When that happens, we will be able to get all the information that we need as far as the public. Then we'll be able to make a more well-informed and objective decision and objective awareness, as opposed to running with this fear narrative about queer people and using this as a way to validate it. And like I told you, in the 60s and 70s, girl, whenever oppressed groups of people start to rise up, your oppressor will find any way to discredit you. Even if it don't even involve your ass, they will find a way to make you involved with it. So we're going to see what the fuck 2024 gives. But overall, accountability is coming for everybody. So for everybody that's on the right side, the left side, and in between, baby, it's going to rain on everybody. It's going to rain on your head. So I hope that y'all have y'all rain gear on. I hope y'all have the strongest, most expensive, reliable umbrella that you can purchase. And in the words of motherfucking New Edition, bitch, can you stand the rain? Because the floodgates of heaven are about to open the fuck up on everybody. So again, we're going to continue to follow this as it progresses. Anyway, thank y'all for taking the time out to listen to this live one tonight. Please make sure that y'all hit the like button, because that helps this channel to grow in the algorithms. Okay, we are almost at 780 subscribers, so we're kind of having like a little steady push, which is kind of dope. So I'm so happy about that. We're almost at 1,000. Okay, that's going to be the first mile mark, and I can't wait to reach it. It's dope. If you like the vibe over here on Bubzdagawd, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell so that you can stay up to date with all of my random lives and videos. Okay, and also I'm going to ask you to please share my content. If there's anything in this live that I said or that I've shown that kind of gave you a little bit more clarity on things and it hit your spirit and you feel compelled to share it in other spaces to kind of help generate very much needed conversations, please make sure you do that by screen recording it and then putting it on your social medias, and also tag me in them as well. I am Bubzdagawd everywhere. All right, and if you feel compelled and you're still in a criminal spirit, you can definitely hit your boy up in the Cash App down below, $Bubzdagawd. Anything you send will be dope, because I'm just grateful and appreciative of it. I'm getting all of my blessings, okay? And until next time, everybody, peace and love. Bubzdagawd is signing out. Peace. Love never dies, just choose to be.